be wet.
Yeah, here. I got some.
Like, it's okay. Don't worry about
here.
It.
Here. See, look, people helping people. I'm always looking out for the big
cool,
guy.
That's cool, man.
That's what friends are for.
It's good to see you, bud. It's good to see
it's
you.
It's good to be back with you.
Randy, first of all, thanks for meeting with us.
Listen, guys, no problem. Thank you for taking time, for making time.
And for budget, too.
It's a big thrill for me to get to talk to you guys. We got some questions. First of all, we want to hear how the trip went. The trip was fantastic. Thank you for asking. We picked Neil up in the city, got to see his home environment a little bit, and then we started making our way up through the gorgeous Northeast, guys. It was peak fall colors.
Wild stomping grounds.
Yeah.
How much was the budget?
Budget was $500, same as it always is.
How much did all the golf cost?
You know, I'd have to ask my associate, Neil, who's not here. I feel like I'm being tag-teamed a little bit.
So, like, tight budget. Why'd you guys pick New York?
We were a little hamstrung. Neil was in the midst of training. Like every day for his big charity boxing match.
I'm training for a charity boxing match called Haymakers for Hope to raise money for cancer research and treatment. And my mom is 20 years breast cancer free, so I'm kind of doing it in her honor. And my Aunt Kathleen passed away 3 years ago, quickly, from lung cancer.
So he couldn't get away from training for more than a day. So we flew in Saturday morning, and he was able to get his workout sparring session in Saturday morning while DJ and I were flying.
At the beginning of the year, I thought like, hey, I like to have like a big physical goal. Mm-hmm. And this was kind of that. It was the one goal that I was like, giving me a little bit of like punch in the gut. Like, yeah, you really want to do that? And then it's like, you know what? That's making me feel that way. That's probably what I should do.
Hey, bud.
Good morning. Hey, I've been working like three jobs. Probably why I never see y'all. Probably why I never have time for the fake friends I won't be y'all. Welcome to Newark. Oh, God, I've been running now. Up early when the sun is out.
Not setting out my own soul, but those real ones, they coming out. Well, I slept through the coffee cart on the plane. I did have an apple, which I brought from home. Big decision. I don't know whether to get a little cup of coffee, breakfast. Neil said he might have a surprise for us. So.
Just looked. Uber X is going to be like $42.
That's not going to work.
Which I don't think is going to probably work.
Listen, can I say something?
Yeah.
The kid's always been a big fan of public transit.
Really?
Yeah.
Like what particularly?
Any planes, trains, automobiles. If it's public, it's me. Okay, I'm working on a Wednesday, then up again the next day. So-and-so is popping, man, I skip him like he leg day. Kick it like I'm Pele, I never care what they say. Put myself on Spotify, so every day my payday.
What's up, Dave? Well, we got on the right train, but it's going the wrong direction.
Well, we'll just get off at the next one and we'll flip it around.
So we're going to have to disembark.
That'll be train number five.
Neil's probably going to be done with this sparring session.
Yep.
This has actually been a very good development for me. I was really worried I was going to get hazed and forced into the ring. That's right, I'm coming back like OJ, like a running back in his old days. Still rocking those OJs. My paychecks get a little bigger, but that don't change me or make me rich. Gentlemen!
Hey!
Hey! What's up?
Randy, you go the wrong way on the subway?
No, listen, I think we were just both kind of blindly getting on any train that came up. We were on five trains. We were on an airplane that left Jacksonville at 6 a.m. Well, we're happy to be here.
Yeah.
How was boxing?
You know what? I got knocked around a little bit this morning. But you know what? I threw a few myself. So
yeah? Hey, yeah? Are you going to be okay to drive? You have CTE?
Well, we got to talk about that.
I saw some pictures. You guys went to Google?
Yes.
Did you pay for your lunch at Google?
Well, no. Everything's free at Google. As Neil being an employee there.
I mean, is it really free, though?
We'll let that slide.
Well, listen, asking me, have they cost society in a multitude of ways? Maybe.
We'll take the boys on a little bit of a tour. Show them the bike room, you know, take a little shower, kind of get myself back to neutral after getting a few head body shots in the ring, you know?
What does googly mean?
It means don't be ego. Do the right thing.
Yeah?
Do unto others as you would like done to you.
Okay. Has Google co-opted the golden rule?
I think so. They've made it their own.
And then we're going to maybe go get some snacks from Uncle Larry. Thanks, Sergey.
That's fine. We're looking for that.
We'd like a free lunch, guys.
We'd like that. We sent them with a budget, and I'm sure you guys stuck to the budget.
Well, that was part of our plan, and we loaded up on snacks, so we were all carrying a bunch of stuff underneath our shirts on the way out.
Got a lot of different sparkling waters.
Yeah. There. Neil made coffee for me. It was fantastic.
What do you think, big guy?
Well, this is going to be good. That was kind of the big issue last time, was not having, like...
Just, like, snacks.
It's good to go breakfast.
Yeah. Please. No, Neil, this is fantastic, bud.
The treats are kind of... These are fall. These are my f***ing go-to. Dark chocolate, granola bites. Seaweeds. There's all the good stuff. Daddy likes.
Yeah, that's not googly. How many do you take?
Four.
Did it train you to be a barista here?
Yeah, I can make a good red eye, black eye.
I think it's like not done right, but the big guy won't know the difference.
Sally, it's the fruits only and the walnuts, I didn't realize.
Yeah, man, that's gonna be a problem.
That's gonna be a problem, so we have an allergy.
Might wanna wash that off, huh? Okay, you know, it's an unsafe work environment when Big Randy's around.
It was googly that he said something, though.
That's a good point.
Yeah, I did want to be honest.
That's very googly.
Well, hey, this is a treat.
Mm-hmm.
Cost?
$3.99, baby.
Ooh, boy, we like that.
We got some palm holds up here. I'm thinking that, I mean, it's a kind of a sketchy little up here. We got to, like, kind of crimp it. But I got some good beta from another Googler that I think I can pull this move. You're rolling! Saddle up in there. Randy, I've seen some issues in your...
My old...
Your L5. I don't think it was sized properly for the big guy.
You can see all the blood rush in your face. This is a bad look.
This is good for business.
Oh my gosh. Wait till you see how red this looks on camera. Hit the road.
Yeah, it's time to go launch. The Big Apple to the Apple Orchard. Let's go.
Hey! How we doing?
Hey, what's happening?
Well, you know, we're on the Merritt Parkway. We're getting vertical into Connecticut. I got the big guy, he's driving here.
Hello!
Yeah, we're going from the Big Apple to the Apple Orchard.
Well, so the first round was a little unique in that we went up to the Lyman Orchards golf complex in Connecticut.
And we're gonna play a lovely nine holes here in the twilight hours. I think we're gonna make a run at the mega bonus today too.
But wait, is the mega bonus in play for nine holes?
It absolutely is. But when I start bucking my head at the Apple Orchard, you guys could probably cancel Christmas.
We just got done playing some golf, private golf, of course, yeah.
Poosh, Johnny Thompson, Callaway on it, and Every.
Was Super Chef Bobby Flay there? Was the Cubes there? All right, cool. You know, I mean, just a few more name drops there at the private golf course, you know? Like, you know, we're probably just going to be Big Randy and I out there today.
In the interest of full transparency, I want you guys to know we got from Newark Airport into Manhattan to meet Neil for $10. We had to ride like five different trains.
They were 2 hours late.
Yeah.
Is it sweater weather?
It is mega sweater weather.
Sure.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's nice. And cool.
55 degrees.
It's crisp. It's kind of getting our Henry David Thoreau on, I think. I think I'm going to get pretty transcendental over the next couple days. Cheers.
Awesome. Cheers, crack on.
Cheers.
Crack on.
They have two 18-hole courses, a Robert Trent Jones and a Gary Player, your boy, two separate 18s. But we chose to play the Apple Orchard 9, which is this little 9-hole course.
I admittedly don't know a ton about it at this point. It sits in an actual apple orchard, so I'm hoping, you know, I'm hoping the cider's bountiful.
Didn't really go through many orchards per se. It was orchard adjacent, I guess.
Did you fill your bag up with a bunch of apples?
No, but they had cool little tea markers that were apples. But they were a different color.
So the sun came out for us. I think it's going to be a lovely afternoon.
Crisp fall ball.
Yeah.
Let's go launch them. I'm an X, man. X going to give it to you.
I'm going regular chrome soft.
How did you guys do last time with the one sleeve rule?
I was all out on like this third hole of our second round, but I was able to find a couple.
Luckily, Callaway's taking over the world.
Yeah.
We found a lot of lost Callaways.
I thought the deal was 18 holes a day, wasn't it?
No. It was just a round. No, yeah. It was a round. Whatever constitutes a round.
It's pretty easy to get under budget with 9-hole rounds.
It's also easier, we thought, to get under par, but neither one of us broke par.
It's a par 29. I think it's ripe. It had a little rain, so it should be pretty soft.
Well, the mega bonus is tough with this many par threes.
It is. That's true.
Candidly.
But, I mean,
knowing
honestly,
what I know about your ball striking.
You're saying it's tough or it's easier for us.
No, I'm saying it's harder to shoot under par with this many par threes.
I didn't like my chances.
I feel like you make your hay on the par fives, but...
I probably do.
We'll see. We'll see.
I assume we're playing the back tees?
The Apple 9 is a whopping 1,556 yards from the dippies.
We like that.
Hey, shout out to the homies.
Yeah.
Thinking about you. Love you guys. Episode 2, here we go.
Oh, wait. Number 2, 301 yards. One of two par fours out here. And the kid's got the disco stick out. It's time to get involved, as they say. Or as I say. Nobody else says that. I say that.
Oh my God, going in.
That might go in the hole.
Oh my God.
Dial.
I don't know if we were gonna be able to see that.
Oh my God, that was good.
Can you guys see that? It's landed about...
I've been the best driver of my life.
Landed soft about 10 yards left of the hole. 10 feet left of the hole. Jesus.
I took a really big swing at that too.
Get you with any of the pelt.
Get some good ones?
It's a little wet out here.
All right, so allegedly this hole is 301. There's the pin. There's where Neil's ball landed and stopped. Almost spun it back with the driver there.
Oh, yeah.
It's good by me there, bud. Good bird.
Yeah, we'll take that one.
Neil even. Randall even.
What are you, DJ?
I'm one under, but look, nobody wants to hear about that. That's all right.
What's with the orange apples? I'm feeling like some GMO vibes out here. I'm not cool with it. Monsanto, get the f*** out.
Oh, it's
like kind of like a diet beer.
What do you mean?
No, it's like a Coke Zero or like a beer at zero. It's like no calories.
No calories. No sweet. No artificial sweetness.
No artificial. It's like not huge, but it, you know, it still gives you the vibes of it. Callaway. Callaway's two.
You got a good look at it. You got a good look at it though.
Didn't that look like it was in the?
Hey man, we gotta think positive, think and move forward here.
All right. Thanks for finding it.
But
yeah, that's kind of where I'm looking.
All right, maybe like right here. I won't touch because we don't want to do a Tron.
I'm in agreement. Oh god, that's a bad five.
He's kind of got some Dontrell Willis vibes with that hat on.
Whoa, the best pull of the day.
Good swing.
Ah, great swing.
Feel free to go in.
Be the right club.
Oh.
Is that good?
Yeah, Randall, what a bounce back. What a bounce back, buddy.
Come on, baby.
Great shot, bud.
Yeah, thanks. You guys don't want to see that one, do you?
Guys,
never a doubt there.
Not stepping through the throw on the four footers.
Hit it, Dontrell.
He's losing speed in the late innings.
Oh, do it.
All right, 314, par four, the finishing hole. A lot of shit out there. How's the ball count, guys?
I'm down one. So I have two left.
You're all good?
Good. Oh, no, went the other way. It's gone. I saw a splash.
Venus!
I love the people up here.
I think they yelled penis at us. Penis.
Did that mess you up?
Nah, I played right through it.
That's a fun way to finish. But
it's always a pleasure with you, big guy.
Hell of a first round.
I think I was three over. I know it's three over.
So you know what? It's 32. I think I was two, one. I was three over as well.
Okay. Right?
Couple 32s for the kids. Man.
You know, you can't come out here expecting to win the mega bonus every round. I think we left a few out there. We always do.
Well, that's tough. You know, you just don't have quite the warm up that maybe you're.
I
don't even want to blame it on that because I never warm up. But you know, being up
at we get loosey goosey with a few shots. Like
4 a.m.
You know, it's a loosey goosey edda, and it continues. You can't win the money round on day one, but you can certainly lose it because I'm probably, and you are a little bit too, a mental midget.
Yeah,
you're like a big guy with like mentally like might be small.
Yeah,
sometimes.
No, I think that's right.
What do we think of the course?
Oh, it was delightful. It was absolutely delightful.
It was a treat. I'll say this, you know, they got some rain, but if these greens are
rolling,
I know
quick.
You don't like firm and fast, but if they're
talking firm and fast again, I mean,
if they're dried out, like they're a lot of fun.
Stop saying firm and fast. Let's say if the greens were quicker, if they were dried out. Thank you.
I mean, it is.
I will say this though. Fun. One major complaint is it's a little bit of false advertising because there's no orchard out here.
We thought we were gonna be like playing through an orchard.
And it's nature's toothbrush, and I was looking forward to maybe picking one and getting after it, a Granny Smith or something.
All right, there you have it.
Pleasure, guys.
Yeah, thank you. Favorite kind of apple?
I've always been a Granny Smith guy. Golden Delicious is kind of a classic. It's a little bit plain Jane though. I might have these Macombs, spicy sweet tart flavor. Might have my name on it. Cheers. I hear at the Middlefield Pizza.
Those mountains are blue.
Restaurant.
No,
it's the Middlefield Pizza Restaurant.
Yes.
And our waitress is delightful.
The best.
She said it might be the smallest town in Connecticut. I'd like to check that out, but I think that's awesome if it is. Anyway, we just got a really solid food alliance. We got a Tony special on half. We held the pepperoni and we held the mushrooms. And then we did pepperoni on the other side because DJ's a picky eater. And then we got some wings because we didn't eat breakfast or lunch. Well, we had a little breakfast. It was $3.99, though, you know what I'm saying? And we got a couple of Coors Lattes, and I'm gonna take a sip of that bad boy.
Cheers.
See, that's a low-cut pizza.
You okay?
I'm hot. Kind of coming down to the wire here. Airbnbs. Our house rules, be kind to animals. Don't get wasted. Smoke outdoors. Be thoughtful of other people.
Sounds very googly.
That is googly.
Yeah, that's pretty
reminder
much
googly. Reminder that our house has only one bathroom, so baths and shower may need some coordinating. That's okay. Private room in the farm stay.
What is a farmhouse?
I think so. Hosted by Janice. It can sleep three easily and four or five in a jam. Our home is an art piece located in heaven.
What?
Close to the fabulous town of Shelburne Falls. Worth a web search. Okay, well, we can Google that. That'd be googly.
And then we may be going to the farmhouse on the Vermont border.
All right.
Neil, can you get us some good farmhouse vibes?
Fish? Anastasia, bro. John Fisherman on the drum.
Oh, side. Bro, I was at this, like, Noblesville 98
dude,
show.
What show is it? Oh, this is my 67th show. Bro, I've been following him up and down the coast. Bro. They're unbelievable.
Oh, my God.
Dude, I can't believe it. Fisherman on the set was unreal. He was just murdering those fills. And Trey Anastasia, what a star.
Oh, what's your favorite Fish song?
Oh man, what is my favorite Fish song? You know, I like them all, man.
Because you only know Farmhouse.